Today our topic is fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are basic human rights that are the natural rights. Major constitution of the world include these fundamental rights, just like Bill of Rights of USA, Bill of Rights of UK. India also borrowed these fundamental rights from the USA. Motilal Nehru Committee had demanded these fundamental rights as far as back as in 1928. After that, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru passed their objective resolution in Constituent Assembly in 1946. This objective resolution include some basic rights, preambles, and some DPSPs, Directive Principle of State Policies. Fundamental rights comes under Part 3 of the Constitution. These cover Article Number 30 to 35. Now understands in details. Now this is the constitution, and our constitution divided into different parts, just like the fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are the natural rights, or these are the basic human rights. Generally, fundamental rights cover the political rights or the civil rights. Second one is legal rights. Legal rights divided into three parts: political rights, economical rights, and civil rights. Political rights, just like equal access to all the political office. To become the member of parliament, to become the member of state legislature, prime minister and president, all are the political rights. Right to vote is also political rights. Now economical rights, just like wage, equal pay for equal work, profession, trade, business, all are the economical rights. Civil rights. Civil rights related to right to property. And most of the rights that are conferred by our constitutions and law are called civil rights. There are some statutory rights also. Statutory rights generally provide or created by the executive resolution. These rights may be part of the constitution or may be out of the constitution, just like Manrega, or RTI right to information act are parts of the statutory rights. And these rights are out of the constitutions, while the National Human Rights Commission is within the constitution. Now, definition of fundamental rights. Constitution does not provide any kind of definition of fundamental rights. Supreme Court from time to time interpret different part of the constitutions. Just like in 1967, there was a highlighted case, Golaknath versus State of Punjab case. In this case, Supreme Court first time defined these fundamental rights, that fundamental rights are the basic human rights. These are essentials for the physical, intellectual and spiritual development of human being. So fundamental rights cannot be amended by the parliament because these are so basic in nature. And parliament cannot amend these fundamental rights under Article 368. This Article 368 provides authority to parliament to amend any part of the constitutions. Now another case, Keshavananda Bharathi versus State of Kerala case in 1973. In this case, 13 judge constitution bench overruled its previous decisions of case of Golaknath versus State of Punjab case. This time, Supreme Court ruled that fundamental rights can be amended or changed or abridged by the parliament for the greater interest of the society. But basic structure of the constitutions cannot be changed or amended by the parliament. Now this basic structure doctrine came out of this case. What is this basic structure of constitutions? Means basic structure that are necessary for the maintain the sanctity or the originality of the constitutions. Independence of judiciary, sovereignty, integrity, just like your secularism, socialism, democracy, all are the basic part of the constitutions. Now characteristics. Fundamental rights have different characteristics, just like these are negative in nature. Negative means these prohibited state to take certain actions. The Supreme Court is the guarantor of fundamental rights. It can restrict the state from violating the fundamental rights of anybody. Consider there was a case of Narmada Bachao Andolan. In Narmada Bachao Andolan project was delayed for a long time because this affecting the rights of the people, right to livelihood, right to habitat, etc. So these fundamental rights are negative in nature. Next characteristic is these establish political democracy in the country. What does mean by political democracy? Means all the people have equal access to all the political offices. To become the member of parliament, member of state legislature, to become the prime minister, president, and become the judge of Supreme Court, all are the political rights. And in this political democracy, all the public office holders have equal chances or fair chances to lose this office. Third property is justiciable. These are justiciable in nature. Justiciable means Supreme Court is the guarantor of the fundamental rights. It protects these fundamental rights. And fundamental rights can be enforced by the Supreme Court or High Court. Any persons can directly reach to Supreme Court under Article 32 or High Court under Article 226 for the violation of fundamental rights. So these all are the major characteristics of the fundamental rights. All other characteristics we will discuss when we have differentiated the fundamental rights and the direct principle of state policies. Now fundamental rights available for the citizens. Some fundamental rights available only for citizens, just like Article number 15, 16, 19, 29 or 30. While rest fundamental rights are applicable for the citizens as well as foreigners. Types of the fundamental rights. Basic constitutions provide 7 types of the fundamental rights. The 44th Constitution Amendment Act in 1978 removed right to property from the list of fundamental rights and included it within the legal rights under Article 300A. So right to property is no more a fundamental right. Present constitution thus constitutes six types of the fundamental rights. Just like number one, equality of law or right to equality, Article number 14 to 18. Right to freedom, Article number 19 to 22. Right against exploitation, Article number 23, 24. And right to freedom of religion, Article number 25 to 28. Educational and cultural rights, 29, 30. 31 was repealed. This was related to right to property, and 32 is right to constitutional remedies. So all six types of the fundamental rights presently available in the constitution. Now, Article number 12, definition of state. Definition of state includes the four points. Number one, Union Parliament plus Union Executive. This Parliament include the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha or President. President is integral part of the Parliament because when a law passed by both the House of Parliament, it sent to the President for his assignment, and President assign this law, then it become an act. Otherwise it lapses. It does not become an act. This Union Executive, Executive is a body of members which look after the implementation of law. Second point is state legislative plus state executive. Third point, any local government. Or fourth one is any local authority and the government of India. So all these four points cover under definition of state. Why definition of state is important? Definition of state is important because when any person approaches to the Supreme Court or any against the decision of the government, then he has to show that authority come under the state. Otherwise, the court can refuse him to entertain his case. Now, Article number 13. Article number 13, first provision. State shall not make any law which is inconsistent or in derogation of fundamental rights. Inconsistent means which is contradictory to the fundamental rights or which is derogation to the fundamental rights. Derogation means going astray. So state shall not make any law which is contradictory to the fundamental rights, which is going astray from the fundamental rights. Now, doctrine of eclipse. Doctrine of eclipse is very important. It related to the pre-constitutional law. What is pre-constitutional law? Pre-constitutional law can be defined as the law which included in the original part of the constitution before 26 January 1950. All are called the pre-constitutional law. So any law which is subsequently overridden by the new law, then earlier law does not cease to exist or it only goes into the dormancy state. When new law or overridden law is diluted, deleted, then earlier law come into operational. You can understand directly by that. If pre-constitutional law is replaced by new law and new law is diluted, deleted, then the earlier law become operational or become functional. Now, Article 13, third provision. Before third, we have to cover second provisions, that is to protect or ensure the fundamental rights and consider any law which is inconsistent or in derogation of fundamental rights as null and void. Article 13, third provision, judicial review. It provides constitutional basis for judicial review. Supreme Court has the power of judicial review. Under judicial review, Supreme Court can declare any law passed by the Parliament as nullified, unconstitutional, ultra vires. Just like consider recently a National Judicial Appointment Commission in 2015 when Parliament passed this 99th Constitution Amendment Act, then Supreme Court repealed it or consider it unconstitutional because it impacts the independence of judiciary, and independence of judiciary is basic structure of the constitution. So under judicial review, the Supreme Court check the constitutionality of the law, and if it is not following the constitution, then it can declare it null and void. Now Article 13, 4th provision. It includes that no part of this article shall be amended under Article 368. Article 13 is not applicable to amendment of the Constitution under Article 368. Article 14th. Equality before law and equal protection of law. Equality before law means all the persons are equal in the eyes of law. This is the negative concept because it considers all people equal in all circumstances. It does not consider the circumstances. This is negative concept borrowed from the UK. And there is exceptions, that is president and governor. No criminal inquiry can be initiated against the president or governor whatsoever. President or governor cannot be arrested or detained. Only a civil proceeding can be initiated against the president or governor. So these are very eminent persons and some immunity or rights, special rights enjoyed by the president or governor. Now equal protection of law. Equal protection means equal treatment in equal circumstances. Consider tax. Tax is imposed high on the rich people and imposed low on the poor. Means persons who is earning more than 10 lakh have to pay approximately 30% tax. When person earning less than 1 lakh don't have to pay any kind of the tax. So this is the positive concept because it considers circumstances. This borrowed from USA and there is no exceptions in this case. So Article 15. Prohibition of discrimination on the ground of race, religion, caste, sex and place of birth. All the persons are prohibited from discrimination on these grounds. All the people have equal access to shop, restaurant, hotels and public places. There are some exceptions, just like you can consider some reservation. The reservation is applicable on the social economic backwardness. And women or children also excluded from this. The state can make certain safeguard for women and children. Other OBC, SC, STs, reservation is provided in the educational institutions. Now Article 16. 16th, first provision. Equality of opportunity in the matter of public employment. Means all the people have equal opportunity in public offices. Public offices consider those offices which are created and maintained by the public money. Money from consolidated fund of people. 16th, second provision. No citizen on the ground of race, religion, caste, sex, place of birth be ineligible or discriminated for the public employment in the office under the state. So this is second point. Now Article number 16, fourth provision. State can make any law for providing the reservations to the any backward class which in opinion of state is not adequately represented in the state. Just like a state can make some reservations. SCST's reservations was provided in 1993 on the recommendation of Baba Khalilkar Committee. And in 1978, on the recommendation of Mandal Commissions, OBC reservation, how much? 27% was provided. So there was a major highlighted case that was Indira Sahani versus Union of India case in 1992. Indira Sahani challenged the Union government that Union government cannot provide it 27% reservations for the OBCs because it is violations of the Article number 14 and Article number 16. So Supreme Court upheld the decision of the government and said that Union government can provide it reservation on the basis of social economic backwardness and OBC deserve for the reservation. But sometimes what happens? This political party is provided reservations on the vote bank politics. So this should be distinct. Then Supreme Court imposed certain restrictions, just like maximum reservations limit is 50%. Second point, reservation can be provided on the social or economic backwardness, or reservations is not applicable for the criminal. Number fourth point is, the reservation can be provided by the executive bodies, and reservations is not applicable for the institutions which are research based institutions. Now article number 17, abolition of untouchability and prohibition of its practice. Untouchability was abolished and no citizens on the ground of untouchability or on the ground of religion cannot practice the untouchability. All peoples are restricted. So in this article 17 there were two provisions, Civil Rights Protection Act 1955 and Civil Rights Protection Act 1977. In this act, the act made these cognizable and uncompoundable offense. Cognizable means the persons who found guilty of untouchability can be arrested without any warrant, and persons who found guilty of untouchability cannot compromise with the aggrieved person, that is uncompounded. Article number 18 says that the abolition of titles except academy and military. So all the titles are abolished, just like Rai Bahadur, Khan Bahadur, and no citizen of India shall accept any titles from any foreign countries. In 1954, four award was introduced, that was Bharat Ratna, Padam Vibhushan, Padam Bhushan and Padam Shri. In 1977, the Janata government came to the power and this abolished all these awards, saying it is violation of article number 18. Then it is okay, or I should continue?
Okay, sir.
Okay. It is enough?
Enough, sir.